going, and we are the Melee Analyst Panel. What's up, guys?
Hey, how's it going, guys? Yeah, that's good. Okay, is this good?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah. That's,
yeah, just like bend it a little closer. Just okay. Like, I gotcha.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thanks a lot.
All right, we're good. All right, great. So, sitting next to me is the legendary Luigi player. I have to say that every time, Calm Master. And then over on my far right is Vish.
Yo.
The Falcon
up,
player. And
Not Aaron Styles, as it says here, but Ammon Styles.
Yeah, thanks for the correction. Yeah, it's A M M O N. No worries, though.
And yeah, we're going to be talking about pretty much everything that's been happening here so far. From pools all the way up to top 8 where we are sitting right now, and in the next about hour before top 8 of Melee gets going.
Sweet.
We don't have the paper, the schedule. Ask Dennis. But yeah, so like, let's see. We do have. Let's talk about the players that we have here really quick. We have Drug Fox here.
Drug Fox.
He's obviously the big one.
Definitely.
Like nobody really expected him to come out. He did register pretty late.
Yeah, it's kind of messed up the seeding, I think, a little bit. He ended up.
Here's a bracket.
Here's a bracket. Well, we have a bracket right here too.
Yeah, sweet. Double bracket.
But yeah, what I was looking for was the piece of paper that had the schedule on it.
Oh, yeah. Right, the schedule of events, like this thing?
No, not the schedule of events, okay. But the schedule of what we were talking about. Okay, so we're going to start with pools, though.
Okay.
And just go through notable pools.
Yeah.
But yeah, so Drug Fox is here. We've got Silent Wolf, obviously. We're up in the Northwest, so he's a big force here. At all the Northwest majors, I believe he's been to every single one. He's won most of them with Bladewise. Usually trailing in a second or third, depending on the attendance here.
Yeah.
And okay. up here at Northwest Majors, we have had a lot of SoCal. Well, not SoCal. I think once we had SoCal, we've had NorCal. We have a lot of Canada. Got some people from East Coast. Sometimes we get Mewtwo King. So we got a pretty good assortment of players coming over here.
Yeah, great variety, definitely. This is thinking, I guess, from my opinion, this is my first Northwest Major, so it's cool being out here. It's amazing seeing how much the scene has grown since I've been here. It's been almost about 3 years since I've been out here. I've been living in Hawaii, so you know, it went from being 30-man tournaments, from what I remember, to you know, plus 200 at this thing. So it's been awesome seeing how the community's grown and how the players have improved. It's definitely been challenging to get back into the scene.
Have you been keeping up with it, Ammon? Like, have you been watching the top level tournament scene?
Yeah, I have. That's a great question. I have been watching videos, but as far as playing, you know, it's just like there's such a big chasm between playing and watching, I guess. I mean, watching is good, but you know, it's playing, it really comes down to you got to go to the big tournaments.
Who are some of your newer players that have kind of emerged in the last couple of years?
Oh, yeah, great question. It's good to see Chip doing so well. He used to be a big Brawl player, and so like I know he, at some point, I guess he transitioned to Melee, back to Melee. So it's really good to see him doing so well. So he's one of the up-and-coming, I think. And then also, who else on here? I mean, we got Vish over here. Didn't even enter the tournament. But he's been up-and-coming for the past couple of years. Getting really good. So, you know, these are all guys that have kind of been in the scene for a while. But then there's also Fat Goku. He's from Oregon, though, so I'm not sure.
Right.
Yeah, I guess he has been coming up in the last about 2 years. He's been playing about 2 years, and he's been training his butt off with Eggs.
Yeah.
He was actually just eliminated Eggs, which was... Eggs, it's so funny. Like, Eggs is always saying, no, I'm going to come back, I'm going to beat Fat Goku. Uh-huh. It's going to be over. And after he beat him, he stood up and he said, your king has returned.
That guy cracks me up.
But yeah, so let's check out some of the early pools.
Yeah. Let's do it.
I know that Drugged Fox had a pretty good set with Eggs early on.
Oh yeah, he did.
But right now, let's start. We'll start by going over our top 16 or top 8 rather, and then we'll talk about everyone or like you know the path that they took to get here. Silent Wolf, we probably don't need to talk about him that much because, I mean, it's pretty clear the path he took, just straight through everybody.
Yep. He's super good.
And then just below Silent Wolf, actually, we're having Chip face off against Silent Wolf. Chip, a really old school player in the Melee scene. I believe he used to play Young Link. I remember him teaming with Deva a lot for this thing called Team 7 Years. They do Link and Young Link. But nowadays, he plays Marth.
Marth, huh?
And he's doing pretty good. I heard he took out Fat Goku pretty handily. I heard he handled that match really well. Vish, you saw that, right?
Yeah. He beat him pretty easily. It seemed like he had Fat Goku's number. He didn't have too much problems with dealing with Fat Goku. His punish game was way better than Fat Goku's, honestly. So even though Fat Goku was getting a couple of the interactions, he just wasn't getting much percentage off of it, unfortunately. So
yeah,
Chip just kind of, I think it was a 3-0.
Chip really? Away, Adam?
Yeah.
Okay. That was a good one.
But then further down, so why don't we, like, let's try to find Chip's pool. Let's see which pool Chip was in. And
yeah.
You guys can go down the list while I try to find Chip's pool of players that we have.
Okay.
In the top 32.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, if you are just tuning in, here with that we are on the front page of Twitch. So if you're just tuning in right now, we are on twitch.tv/teamchaos. You can click on the big stream and you can join us in the main channel, which I encourage you to do so because we're going to have some really good Melee coming up. We've had some great sets, even with people that aren't out yet. There was one I recall, Balloon versus Out the Cuts. You might remember Balloon from Paragon. He had a great set versus Axe.
Oh, yeah.
And him versus Out the Cuts was quite the set. It was three stocks back-to-back by each of them.
Oh, man.
Take it.
Huh.
Let's see here.
But it really looks like most of the pools were mostly for seeding into the top 32 bracket, because there wasn't a lot of great, there wasn't like a lot of like heavy hitters, you know, taking each other out, many upsets. Actually, and know what? Big D, who actually just got eliminated by, from the tournament by Kaw Master. You, that's right.
Sorry about that, Big D.
But. Yeah, he was pulling upset after upset, actually. He went through a lot of people. He went through Dr. Z. You may know him as Sheridan in the Smash scene.
Oh, yeah. Sheridan's good.
Yeah, and he played a ton of Puffs, and then Sheridan played a ton of Ice Climbers. And Sheridan is actually still in the tournament, I believe.
Really?
He made it to top 8?
Wow.
I think so. He may have, maybe he lost to eBay. I'm not sure. I didn't see that match. Did you see that match happen? Up here
eBay.
On the main stage?
It didn't happen up here.
It didn't. Okay, well, it didn't. I'm pretty sure it didn't happen down there.
Okay, yeah.
Yep, okay, yeah, no. He's still in because still in. Right now the guys that are still in our top 8, we've got Scion from, I think, is he a Canadian?
Yeah,
Scion from Canada.
Yeah.
Lots of strong Canadian showing at this tournament, actually.
Yeah, definitely.
I believe Canadians won Brawl.
Oh,
a couple,
really?
A couple other things. I believe they won Smash 64, too, as well.
Go Canada.
Or got second, at least. But then we've got eBay, Washington's own eBay. Great Falcon player. He's always entertaining to watch versus Melee at Onmi's Dr. Z. 62-bit Blade-wise, Northwest favorite. Really great Peach main. I would say it's pretty clear that he is at least second-best Peach in the nation.
Yeah.
Probably third overall.
Definitely.
And then we've got Silent Wolf versus Chip. And so those are our top 8. But basically, a lot of what we saw in pools was just a lot of really strong play from strong players. There was a few close sets, but it was... it was from players a little bit lower on the skill level, but still had really strong showings, like, even against like the stronger players now.
Yeah.
And you're one of the, okay, you're one of the stronger players. So yeah. Tell me, how was your pool? Was there anyone that was particularly difficult for you to fight in your pool?
Let me think here. Let me look through my pool real fast. Kamaji from Eastern Washington. He's an old school player, so you know he's doing good. So our matches were pretty close. His Fox has really improved over the past few years.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's good to see him still playing. Yeah, he was probably the toughest one, but they're all pretty good. You know, it's just like remember what's his name, Scar, talking about how he mentioned in some commentary how basically you have to fight for your life in pools these days because of how much the competition has grown.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like you pop into pools and then everybody's just good.
Yeah.
Everybody, you can't jump into pools and not know like one matchup.
Exactly.
Because you're gonna run into that one guy that knows the matchup and says, "Oh, okay, you don't know how to fight my character.
Yep.
I'm just gonna."
Yeah, exactly.
I'm gonna exploit the crap out of that.
Exactly. Yeah. So the scene growing has really added a lot of variables into the match outcomes.
Yeah, it is really a difficult it's difficult to get into now. You know, like getting into Melee, you're gonna get your butt kicked for about 3 weeks.
Yeah, at
the start, and it'll be a few months before you feel like you're good enough to go to the pools and the tournaments and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's true. So Vish, what's your opinion on all this?
Yeah. Vish, like, do you think there's anything that was like a major upset?
Major
so
upsets
far,
today. I don't know. Things have been proceeding kind of pretty much as we expect. Blade-wise, Drugged Fox, I think, is going to be kind of interesting. I haven't seen them play before, and I feel like the methodical style of Blade-wise could work out maybe in his favor.
I actually agree with that. Like, I think that Drug Fox is probably the slightly stronger player here.
Yeah,
he does have better results at a national level, but Blade-wise, obviously a really, really solid player, very, very good.
Yeah.
Like we were saying, easily third best Peach overall.
Yeah, at least. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can see that. Yes. Huh.
That's a hard matchup, though. Sheik, Peach, man. Fire Blade-wise, I'd just be really careful, man, because once he gets those down throws on him, it's over, pretty much.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for... I don't know if Sammy gets too much Peach practice. I'm trying to think of who's in Georgia.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. We don't have too many good Sheiks here either, so...
That's true.
It's going to be tough.
Yeah. I hope for the best. Honestly, I'm kind of rooting for Teddy because he's a Washington...
homie.
Yeah, homie. But Drug Fox is awesome, so... Can't blame him for winning.
Right, right.
Yeah. Let's see.
Hold on. Let me see if I can get Drug Fox on here, because honestly, he's like a really analytical guy.
Yeah,
and talking to him, he just like can talk up a storm about the game pretty well.
All right.
So let me see if I can get him, honestly.
Yeah.
Oh. One sec.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're going to go see if we can get Drug Fox on here. We probably will. He's in commentary right now. He's commentating on the secondary stream, which, by the way, is twitch.tv/ZodiacSmash. Shameless plug. That's actually my channel, secondary stream over that way. You don't know where I'm pointing, but it's okay because I'm pointing towards the stream.
Oh, man.
But, yeah, I think we can just... maybe launch into talking about just top 32 and what we saw in top 32.
That sounds good.
Let's see, Silent Wolf versus this was all seeded stuff right there. That was all seeded stuff. Out the cuts, really strong player. He did lose to Silent Wolf though.
Oh really?
Which no surprise.
Yeah, right.
Because Silent Wolf.
Yeah.
Very good. Like Silent Wolf had such a strong showing against Armada at Evo. Did you see that,
yeah,
Matt?
Yeah, he took a match from him, right?
Yeah, he took a match from him, and he was on fire. He was moving fast. He was constantly moving.
Yeah.
It was fantastic. Yeah. I love watching good Melee. And that was some of the best Melee that I've seen. You know, at least that has to do with my region.
Definitely.
And
it was
so
awesome watching those sets.
You know, if he's playing that good right now, then I'm actually super excited to see what Silent Wolf can do against Drugged Fox. Yeah. And because I don't think we've ever seen that ever.
He took him out at EDC3.
EDC3?
Yeah, HTC.
HTC. Yeah. That was
He took him out in winners and losers.
About a month ago, maybe?
I think a few months. Maybe a month ago.
Yeah. You know, which is kind of funny to think about, because Silent Wolf is a player that has actually been criticized for not knowing the Sheik matchup
a lot.
Yes. A couple months ago, there was a Japanese Sheik player that was visiting NorCal, and he was at the Foundry a lot.
Uh-huh.
And Silent Wolf kept getting taken out by him.
Oh.
And I think he played him in grand finals and lost one or two sets to him. And he just has been criticized for being bad at the Sheik matchup. And if he has beaten Drugged Fox at HTC, then obviously he's improved at that, because Drugged Fox is someone who just knows the Fox matchup.
Yeah.
He knows that extremely well. That is his bread and butter with his Sheik.
You're right.
He'll down throw you, reaction tech chase, and he'll go after you.
Yeah.
Although I was watching him versus Eggs actually in pools, and honestly it wasn't in pools, I believe it was in top 32.
Yeah, yeah.
But I don't know if you saw
close.
That one.
Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah. Yeah, it was close.
Yeah. Eggs is good. He's done a lot better this tournament than I thought he would.
Yeah,
his platform game has really gotten good.
He's playing well this tournament, and
yeah.
You know, as a Northwest guy, as an Oregon guy, that's where Eggs is from. Like, right. I'm really happy to see Eggs playing good.
Yeah,
it's funny. You hear the rumors of like Eggs in his prime and like what he can do when he's just like
on point.
Yeah, when he's on point, and I'm like, oh man, do I get to see on point Eggs now? Yeah. Is that gonna be a thing?
I think so. I think we're seeing him right now.
That'd be awesome. I mean, we saw him beat Falcoco. I think. And Fat Goku lost the chip. I think he was kind of down in the dumps, though, a little bit.
Oh, really?
Because of the loss of chip, I heard he just walked off the stage, actually.
Oh, really?
Because chip was just super dominant there. I didn't see that personally. I know Vish did.
Yeah. Who is chip playing? Do you know?
Marth. Yeah, wow. Chip is playing Marth right now. He's been doing great, actually.
Yeah,
And Chip is another player that I've heard a lot of rumors about, and people just tell me, Chip is so good. Chip is so good. You have no idea how good he is because he never travels.
Uh-huh.
And I think that's something that Northwest Majors is actually really good for.
Yeah,
is saying, we've got all these Northwest hidden bosses that don't travel, and then we hold something like Northwest Majors, and they all come down over here.
Yeah.
And they're like, hey, let me show you what I can do. You know, it's our chance to get on the big stage.
That's true.
And say, hey. Hey, we're good too.
Yeah, it's awesome for that reason. Man. Yeah, it looks like I'm probably going to end up playing Eggs. That's my prediction at least.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what's going to happen with Eggs versus Chip. What is it? No, not Eggs versus Chip.
Oh, yeah. Eggs versus eBay problems? No. Myome or Dr. Z. Dr. Z.
I don't know.
What's your opinion of that?
I know. My opinion on that is Falcon doesn't have a great matchup against Jigglypuff.
Yeah.
And like a lot of it is that Captain Falcon just doesn't have the tools to deal with it, so he has to just win the neutral over and over and over and over again.
Oh, it's hard as Falcon.
Yeah, and against Jigglypuff, Falcon has a hard enough time winning the neutral against other high tier characters, but then you throw in Jigglypuff, whose game is
spacing.
Yeah, who's
a neutral.
Yeah, is making you try and commit to the neutral, and then she just wins it.
Yeah, that's so true.
And then it just becomes so difficult for Falcon.
Yeah.
So difficult for Falcon to actually get in there and really win the neutral.
How is Dr. Z? Have you seen him play much?
Yeah.
Dr. Z.
I think. Yeah, that's.
Dr.
Z, Dr. Z, I don't know. Sheridan.
That's right.
I
think him and Shane play all the time. Or Eggs. Oh, yeah, sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, let's go.
You haven't seen him too much, though?
I haven't, seen him too much out of this region.
Okay.
I've seen him play, and he seems like a good, solid player.
Uh-huh.
Not great.
Yeah.
But he's a good, solid player. He's someone you're not going to sleep on. If you do sleep on, then you'll probably lose.
Yeah, okay.
But I don't think he's not one of those, mighty, unbeatable players of NorCal that we hear so much about.
So if you sleep on him, he's going to rest on you.
Ho-ho! Good one. I like it.
Thanks. Oh, man. Yeah, so that should be interesting.
Yeah.
Because the winner of that, plays Eggs. And Eggs, he does not like the Puff matchup. I don't know a Fox who does, but
all the Fox mains will tell you that the matchup is wildly in Fox's favor. Wildly in Fox's favor. You shoot the lasers and then you up smash. That's basically what it is. And there's not a lot Puff can do about it because you have superior ground mobility.
Yeah.
Overpuff.
Right.
But then you start playing the players rather than the matchup, and that can change very drastically.
That's very true.
If you're playing someone super aggressive, and I mean like Mango versus Hungerbox. Like, I can't count the amount of times that Mango has eaten a rest or, like, lost a stock or a match or a set even to Hungrybox because he was too aggressive.
That's so true.
And, like, I've seen that happen against Armada's Peach, too. Mango versus Armada's Peach. I've seen him get too impatient, and he loses because of that.
Oh, yeah. Good point.
But, yeah, it's a similar situation when we're going to be seeing, what was it, like, maybe Dr. Z versus Eggs if eBay happens to lose to Dr. Z. And, I think the way Eggs is playing, like, he is a flashy guy. He is such a flashy player, and he's so much fun to watch. He's one of the funnest foxes to watch.
He's very flashy.
He's one of the funnest foxes to watch, and I'm sure he's just going to be trying to come up with ways to be super flashy and beat Jigglypuff.
You're right.
Which,
where's Dr. Zed from? Is he from Canada?
NorCal.
NorCal.
Yeah.
Oh,
I believe he's from NorCal.
Okay.
And I got the chat in front of me here, guys. So if you know that he's not from NorCal, but I believe he's 15th on the NorCal power rankings. So if you know better, go ahead and throw that out in chat.
Sweet.
Let's see. And then we got Iceman versus Scion.
Oh, yeah.
Iceman, a relatively strong player from Washington.
Yeah, he's power ranked, right? He's 5th or 6th.
Yeah, somewhere around there. We got Silent Wolf, then Bladewise, and Vish was 3rd. He's off the power rankings now by request, actually.
Okay.
And I think, Iceman might be anywhere between 3rd and 5th on the power rankings of Washington.
Yeah, that's right.
I think.
Right on there. And so, who is the other? How do you say this guy's name? The other guy's name?
Oh, Kiri Aoi. I believe that's Scion.
Okay, right, Scion. Okay.
Canadian player.
Okay, is he Sheik?
Fox, I believe.
Fox,
yeah.
Okay, so we got Fox and Marth.
I think so. Which, that's a very volatile matchup, Fox and Marth. And when you put together, like, a strong Marth versus a strong Fox, then it is not, it's no longer about, you know, Marth counterpicking the final destination.
Yeah, you're right. You know, there's more to it. That's a great point. You got to really start mixing things up once you get to the higher level play. I mean, you'll get a few chain grabs at high levels, but nothing that's going to make like a huge, significant difference in the matchup.
Yeah, I mean, you can still get grabbed to death, I mean, but we've been seeing Leffen shine out of those out of those up throws. It's like, all right, Marth, if you're not perfect with these pivot dash dances, these pivot jump cancel grabs, pivot plus jump cancel grab, then I'm just going to shine you out of this and I'm going to be on my merry way.
Yep, exactly. Fox always has an option.
Yeah, so actually, the Fox Marth, at least on Final Destination, that matchup has changed changed drastically in the
you're
last
right,
year.
It has. How would you describe most of like some of the differences?
It's no longer a Marth wins this matchup kind of a scenario. It's Marth has to be super careful in the neutral now.
Yeah.
Because these Fox players are getting better and better at winning the neutral on Final Destination.
That's
and
true.
It's like, you know, the old Mewtwo King on Final Destination tricks that have been working for like the past 4 years.
Yeah.
The Foxes got fed up with it. They said, okay, fine, that's enough. We're done with this. We're going to find a way around this.
That's so true.
And now it's changed where it's not an instant win anymore, and these Marths got to step up their game a little bit.
You're right. It's totally changed. I never thought the neutral game could change so much over the course of, you know, just a few years, but that's Melee for you.
Yeah, Melee is just a fantastic game.
It is.
I mean, you know, from a technical standpoint, you look at the code, the game has not changed since the day it was released. at least not in the U.S.
Right.
You know, we had some changes over in Europe in the European release.
Uh-huh.
But we're playing NTSC over here. We're playing the North America's release over here. And it hasn't changed a bit since the day it was released. But the way people play the game has changed so much that it doesn't
totally
even look like the same
exactly.
game anymore.
That's so true.
Which is, like, it's really a testament to how good the game is and how flexible it is. And, like, you can – everyone has their own style to play in the game.
That's very true. Though Fox is becoming more and more dominant, it seems.
You know, it really is 20XX.
Yeah.
Fox is just, like, a ridiculously good character. Falco, in my opinion, Falco is second best.
Yeah.
And if not second best, he's definitely fighting for that spot between Sheik and Marth.
Yeah, Marth, definitely.
Yeah, and I mean, and then just below that, we're going to have, like, Jigglypuff, Peach, Jigglypuff, Falcon.
Yeah.
And then lower down, it almost doesn't matter.
You're right.
But I just think it's great. Like, I'm just kind of gushing about Melee right now, but I think it's great that we can be like, okay, we have like 6 or 7 viable characters in this fighting game that wasn't even meant to be like a true fighting game, but it turned into that. And we only have like 6 or 7 viable characters. And then when we have 5 different players representing one character, it looks like 5 different characters.
That's so true. Yeah.
And it does take a little bit of familiarity with the game to like notice those differences. But once you do, you're just like, man, this is a beautiful game.
It is very beautiful. It's a masterpiece.
All right, gushing about Melee is over. But yeah, once again, we're at Northwest Majors Drop Zone Edition. We've got Only Smash here. Northwest Majors, known as a Northwest Major for fighting games. And we've got a Smash-only rendition going on right here. And it is really fantastic. We're up in Des Moines, Washington at Highline Community College. If you're wondering where the scene near you might be, that's where it is, up in the Northwest. Yeah, we've got Melee, we've got Smash 64, we've got Brawl even.
Oh, yeah.
And Smash 4. Zero is actually here for Smash 4.
Okay.
Zero is here for Smash 4.
Yeah, Zero. He's cool. He's super good.
Oh, yeah.
He's watching his
match. Yeah, cool guy as well, if you ever talk to him.
Cool.
He's a cool guy, nice guy.
Yeah. Whoever would have thought such huge talent would come from Chile. I guess then. There are great players down there.
Like, honestly, like, Zero kind of came out of nowhere, and This won't be going off topic too much, because he was playing Melee all last year.
Really?
In 2014, actually. He was playing
a
lot of Melee. And he was doing good, too. He beat a lot of big names in Melee. He beat Fiction.
Really?
There was a couple of others. And it was just great. Just, like, speaking about Zero's, like, drive to get better.
Yeah.
He lost pretty badly to Fiction a few months before Evo. And then at Evo, he just, like, straight 2-0'd him.
No way.
Yeah, and it was he'd clearly been working on the matchup.
That's
so
impressive.
You know, go Zero, man.
Yeah,
go Zero. You're definitely doing good. Your drive is awesome.
That is awesome.
But why don't we jump back to talking about this stuff, I guess.
Yeah.
So you might end up, so for you guys who don't know, you do know because his name is right here, but this is Calm Master, the legendary Luigi player. And he's going to end up fighting either Iceman or Scion. And, like, how do you feel about the Marth-Luigi matchup? Like, I hear a lot of people complain about that and say it's a difficult matchup.
Yeah.
But how do you feel about that matchup?
That's a great question. I used to really dislike it just because Marth has so much range over Luigi. But over time, I've really gotten fond of it because, you know, it's kind of like he does have a lot of range on Luigi, but his aerials are a little bit slower. They come out slower than, say, Fox or Sheik or Falco's. So that time difference makes a huge difference for being able to, at least for me, to be able to process and think about what I want to do. And so it's really nice to have that extra time. So I prefer Marth over Sheik, over Fox, over Falco, definitely.
Really? Like, yeah. Over Sheik?
Over Sheik, definitely.
Yeah. Like, I saw you had that set with Fooz Jr.
Yeah, Fooz Jr., that was... he was good, man. He was doing good.
Yeah.
But, yeah, he just got a little shaky. I think he would have had it if he didn't lose his confidence so much. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man, dude, I'm going to tell him that.
All right.
I'm going to tell him that, man.
He needs to hear it.
but, yeah, so the Marth matchup, not too bad. Like, I imagine, like, Marth has great dash dance mobility.
He
like,
does.
Amazing dash dance mobility. But then Luigi's got that wave dash. Like, how does that factor into the neutral game?
Yeah, that's a good question. Basically, it comes down to a lot of the neutral game is dash dancing and wave dashing. So basically, Marth dash dancing around, Luigi waiting for an opportunity to dash in and get a forward tilt or a grab. And that's usually what the neutral game comes down to. Sometimes there's a little bit of aerial spacing, but more so it's just looking for dash dance grabs on Marth's part or looking for wave dashing forward tilts on Luigi's part. And then it just kind of goes from there. Not a lot of combo ability. If Marth can get Luigi above his head, then it's really good for up air combos. And if Luigi can get Marth off the stage, it's pretty easy to ledge guard. So they both have a few different aspects that are good against each other. But yeah, it's a good matchup overall. It's not too bad for either one.
Awesome. So you'd say it's pretty even?
Yeah, it's pretty even.
Awesome. Well, joining us over here is Drugged Fox.
Hello.
Hey.
You guys may know him from his breakout performance his breakout performance at Evo, which I'm pretty sure that was your breakout performance.
That was probably my biggest performance for
and
a while.
Fantastic set against Leffen.
Yeah, the Leffen set was a nail biter, to say the least.
Yeah, so have you been enjoying the tournament?
I've been having fun. There's a lot of people here, but even more room than there are people. I was really surprised, actually. This venue is amazing.
It's nice.
Oh, yeah.
I'd say I was a little too tired yesterday to really enjoy it, but today I've gotten to talk to people more, been more talkative, played a little more. I was on commentary a bit, so it's been fun.
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Oh, yeah. I lost my train of thought. It's gone.
It's okay. So what's happening here?
We were just talking about top 32 and matchups we might see happen and how they're going.
I was on the other stream, and I believe top 8 losers. So we had Eggs upsetting Fat Goku.
Yeah.
We had Sion and Iceman have a very close set, but Sion came out on top.
Okay.
We had eBay honestly dominate Sheridan. I know he's amazing at that matchup, though, versus Puff.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So let's see. I'll go ahead and refresh this.
Yeah.
And see if we can get
our
the
fourth losers match is, I believe, you, right?
Yeah.
Who did you beat to qualify?
Big D.
Luigi Ice Climbers.
Yeah.
Do you feel comfortable in that matchup?
Yeah. Surprisingly, just like because of Luigi's traction, it really makes it easy to get out of Ice Climbers' grabs and stuff.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
And you push them very far back if you hit their shield.
Yeah. Exactly.
Thing.
Yeah.
So we saw eBay beat Dr. Z.
Yes.
Okay, great. So that means we're going to see Eggs versus eBay.
Ooh.
So
didn't
that
I believe eBay beat him the last time they played.
Really?
But I might be wrong.
Maybe. See, now, when you're talking about, like, Eggs and, like, his track record.
That's fair.
It's kind of hard to go, oh, well, they beat him last time, so, you know, it's a sure thing. It's
that doesn't
sure
necessarily
thing,
tell you very much.
Yeah, because Eggs' track record is super inconsistent.
Can we assume it'll be a good set, though?
Yeah,
for sure. He's been playing good today. Eggs has.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's been great, playing great. He had a good set with you.
Yep.
I remember watching that over there. Like, how did you feel about that set?
I'll be totally honest with you. I think he played pretty well. Well, I can't say that for sure, but I will say that I wasn't super worried at the same time.
Yeah.
But that might be, that might just be my mental state. Like, maybe I should have been worried, but I try to never be worried when I play in tournament, if that makes sense.
That does make sense.
Even though it was close, I was like, it's sort of nice to know that I'm supposed to be the better player. And some people see that as pressure to win, but I interpret it as I have confidence that the closer it gets, the more likely I am to play clutch. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, it's a good mentality to have, to just never underestimate or
don't underestimate, but still be confident that you know your skill level.
Like, I think the best way to have confidence in a tournament is to just be confident in what you can do. Don't say, oh, well, I'm expected to win here or they're expected to lose.
It's not about that. I know how to do this and I'm going to do that. Yeah, that totally makes sense.
Yeah, it's exactly about that. It's about what you can do in the tournament.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, so we're going to see eBay and Eggs. And so rough matchup for Falcon. Can be a pretty rough matchup for Fox.
Depending on how it goes, yeah.
Yeah.
I believe you have a secondary Falcon, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, and I played Eggs a lot last night with him. His Fox definitely... Oh, thank you. Sorry.
So you played against Eggs last night.
Yeah, Eggs last night. We did some money matches, Fox-Falcon. It was rough. Definitely.
How did that go? So he did well versus your Falcon?
He did well, yeah.
Did you play Luigi versus him?
I did, yeah.
How was that?
It was good. It was good. But the thing is, me and Eggs have grown up together.
Yeah.
So we played each
other. I remember watching your matches back in the day. Yeah, yeah. Like I said, I've been playing forever, so I used to watch a lot.
Good. It's good to have a fan.
Yeah, I remember, in particular, there's this set where, I believe in the crew battle, you played Amsa at Pound 4.
Yeah.
And one of my friends played Luigi, so, I used to go back and reference that set, and I'd be like, okay, so you should study this, and, here's what Commaster is doing. I still remember that.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. So what's going on now? So we're in our top 8.
Top 8.
Yeah, we
do
we
want to talk about top 8?
Yeah, let's do it.
Why don't we go through top 32 really quick?
Okay, we want to talk about what happened.
Yeah, what happened
thus
to go
far.
This far? Anything that you see that stands out as this was a close match or something like that. We can talk about.
So let's think back. So I've seen most of these sets. The Prime Dr. Z. I think most of these were I actually found it. I didn't see any upsets in top 32, unless I don't know the region well enough. but do you see anything that like was surprising that happened?
Big D pulled some upsets.
Oh, Big D did. So is he? I've heard he was not a Melee player. I'm not sure if that's accurate or not.
No, he is. He started in Brawl.
Okay.
He plays the other game.
Yeah.
And he plays Smash 4 as well. And then he dabbles in Melee.
Okay.
He dabbles in Melee.
I saw he plays Ice Climbers, and he did the sort of what a lot of Brawl players actually do, where they just try to like sit back, and they might not know a lot about Melee, but they play very solid, have good spacing.
Yeah.
If they do very well versus the airborne characters, I've noticed. They know how to deal with the drifts and get under them.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. They know how to handle those floaties.
But you played Luigi versus Big D, and was that close?
Yeah, a couple matches were.
A couple matches were close, but you pulled it out probably solidly.
Yeah, but still, he was adapting really well.
So okay.
Yeah, he's a smart player.
So we had, most of these seem like pretty classic results.
Yeah.
I believe if anyone was watching this stream as we moved on to top 16, we had me versus you. We had, I guess the next match was Fat Goku.
Oh,
and go ahead.
Yeah, actually, I would love to hear about your guys' set.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Because I didn't get to see that.
Well, do you want to talk about it or do I want to talk about it? Or
I want to hear your opinion.
Okay.
First.
My honest thoughts were, so I'll break it down. So game one, he started extremely strong. He took my first two stocks without losing one. And then I two-stocked you that match, I believe.
Yeah, you did.
So it was one of those things where I think the real reason that happened is because FD is a very swingy stage. I don't know who it's better for, but we both destroy each other on that stage. So it's one of those things where I could have been down 1-4 stocks, and I'm still like, Sheik Luigi on FD. He's in the air. He's going to come down and be unsafe, and I can easily get those kills.
Right.
Yeah.
It was like a very back-and-forth match where you guys pretty much just took turns like
destroying each other. We just took turns, and like... He took two, then I took four, but like he could have taken one, I could have taken two, then he could have taken three. Like it's
right.
FD.
That's
the next match, I believe I was ahead for most of it, but then he made a really good comeback and he beat me game two.
That's right. Barely.
Yeah, it was a very close match, but you definitely like made there was definitely a point where like last stock I was like, okay, I'm still up. Momentum's sort of even. Then I got hit one more time and I was like, okay. I believe once he got me off stage on the last talk, he didn't drop anything. He actually got the kill straight up. Oh, Dreamland sort of helped me a lot with the... That's one reason I like Dreamland as Sheik. Wispy pushes me off the platform sometimes when I up B.
Oh, yeah, that was good.
And then I think games 3 and 4 weren't super close.
No, they weren't. You wrecked me.
Yeah, so it was 3-1, though.
Yeah.
I'd say game 1 was sort of back and forth, but 2 stock. Game 2 was super close, but he definitely won. And then games 3 and 4 were definitely in my favor.
Yeah,
awesome. Yeah, I really wanted to come out and watch that, but I was in there.
VODs? You can watch the replays?
Yeah. I can watch the VOD later.
How did you feel about playing me?
Yeah, I felt...
Just
I felt
be totally honest. Okay. I don't know.
I felt very similar. Like, the first match was like, I felt strong, but then I guess for me it was like you started adapting really quickly. I could tell
within the first two stocks.
Within the first two stocks, you adapted extremely quickly, and I was not ready for that.
Okay.
So that was like, wow.
So were you feeling like, all right, I'm pulling ahead, this is my game?
Exactly,
okay,
yeah, that's
okay,
how I felt.
Okay.
Especially because I could tell, like, I guess after playing Silent Wolf a lot, you know, he knows the Luigi matchup so well that's like anybody else is probably not going to know it as well.
Okay.
So it's like, okay, maybe I'll have that edge over you. But really, you just adapted so quick.
Okay.
It's like, man.
That's cool. I'm glad you feel that way.
Oh, you did, man.
I've said this for a long time where, like, people would talk about adapting a lot back in the day and, like, how fast top players can adapt or whatever. And my theory back then, like, 4 or 5 years ago, was, like, as we get very good at Melee, I think we can adapt to, like, anyone within, like, 2 stocks of playing them. Like, back then, it used to be, like, over the course of a whole set, you adapted, like, a little.
Yeah.
As we understand the game better, I'm like, all right, 2 stocks have passed, like, if you haven't adapted by then, like, I think it's, like, really hard to beat someone.
Definitely.
At that point.
Especially with the momentum and everything.
Yeah, that's a very real thing.
Seriously.
Yeah, momentum shifts have gotten more and more frequent in Melee over the past couple of years. And
why do you think that is?
Oh, it's because people are better at the game.
Do you think it's just, like, we know how to hit harder, we know the openings, we know, like...
The punishes,
yeah,
mostly.
Yeah,
the punish game for everyone has gone way, way up.
Yeah.
And because of that, like, everybody's just like, oh, okay, I got, like, one hit on you now. Like, Fox Dittos, for example.
Mess you up.
Yeah, it'll just, like, mess you up. And then, like, oh, now I got a hit. And, like, the momentum just boom, 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 boom.
One thing I think that also contributes to that is not just the punish game once you get a hit, but also the ability to punish things in neutral. For example, you watched Melee 5 years ago. I still think everyone was really good, but you know, you'd get away with a couple things in neutral. But now you do something wrong, like players are like 3 to 4 times more likely to punish you for making that mistake.
That's so true.
Like getting the grab punish or getting the initial hit has also improved a lot.
Yeah.
The neutral, just losing the neutral once has become a really big deal
now. It definitely is. Which is, I think it works in my favor, though, because people started getting scared of Sheik a lot more. Because when I play people, at least, there's this sense of they're either too scared of me to start with because Sheik can, like, tech chase or combo or whatever, or they're not scared at all, which once I grab them once or twice, that instantly changes. I'm like, oh, well, you're probably scared now, which isn't good, though.
Right.
I think they should remain confident.
Yeah, good point. Oh, your Sheik is nasty, man.
I appreciate it. awesome. Like being a Sheik player, like the typical response to my Sheik is definitely not nasty. It's a your Sheik's okay, I guess. You're sort of lame. Like, whatever.
You're sort of lame.
Yeah, like I get that a lot. Even though I think I have like one of the cooler Sheiks, but
definitely.
Your tech chase game is amazing.
Thank you.
Like it's really really good. I mean, like that's definitely what you're known for is your tech
chase
game.
Exactly. And that it sort of shadows over like everything else I'm trying to work on.
Yeah, right. But like I think people look at the tech chase game and they like kind of equate it to wobbling
exactly.
with ice climbers.
Exactly. So I feel like they take that aspect of my game and assume every other aspect of my game matches up with that.
Yeah, and
but all I'm doing is like, well, I have this punish. I'm gonna do the right thing.
Yeah, like this is strictly the best option. And then like it's funny, like Sheik's a long time ago used to do that option all the time.
There was a point where Sheik's tech chased more. For sure.
And then. Like the meta evolved to a point where they're like, oh, let's figure out like combos and stuff like that, and people kind of stopped tech chasing, and now it's being reintroduced into the meta, and people are like, oh, wait, this is back? Are you kidding me?
It's good,
Yeah, it's really good.
So do we want to talk about the rest of top 16?
Yeah.
So what happened after me? Was it Chip versus? Was it either
Chip
Fat
versus
Goku?
Fat Goku? Yeah, and
let's talk about that.
We've talked about that a few times.
Okay,
actually.
Okay, so you guys talked about it already.
A little bit, yeah. Like,
did you guys talk about Bladewise versus Iceman?
No, we haven't talked about Bladewise at all.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So, well, did you guys both watch it?
I didn't. Oh, no, I did not. I watched some of it.
You watched some of it?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, it was.
Tell us about it.
Okay. From what I saw, it was pretty back and forth. I saw most of the first match.
Okay.
Yeah. So. I talked to Iceman about it though.
Oh, that's always interesting. So what does he say?
He says that he pretty much said the exact prediction and outcome that the match had.
So he said 3-0.
Is that what happened?
I thought it was 3-0. It might have been
something
else.
Okay, yeah. He said they usually go back and forth. So he said 3-2.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. So you didn't get to finish the set.
No, I didn't. Yeah, I didn't watch the finishing.
Well, I did get to finish it, and I'll say. Your impression of the first match was true about the next two games.
Really?
I would say they went dead even the entire time, but it's sort of the good player effect where Bladewise being generally considered the better player, it's like he was able to close out more often. He was able to finish more stocks. He didn't choke anything. He hit his punishes. Iceman had, I'd say, enough openings to win the set.
Okay.
But
there's
a difference between hitting the openings and having them.
Good point.
So maybe if I definitely could see a 3-2, no question. But that's not what happened.
Gotcha.
And then what? Silent Wolf versus eBay, I believe, was the other match.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
I didn't see that at all because I was in the other room.
And neither did I. I was also in the other room.
Did you manage to see
that? I saw most of it. Yeah.
Most of it?
Yeah.
Was it even close, or was it just like auto?
I did see part of it. There was some hype moments where like eBay like started to come back, but then Otto just kind of like rolled right back into the.
Okay.
Yeah, eBay played really consistently though for Falcon. Usually, Falcons tend to kind of crack under the pressure.
Be up and down.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay.
But he played really consistent.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
This is looking like a pretty good tournament for eBay. Yeah. I believe he beat Sion. It sounds like he had an acceptable set with Otto. He didn't like get destroyed or anything, and then he beat Dr. Z really. He four-stocked him game one.
Really?
Wow.
Oh,
Puff's his best matchup.
Really?
Oh, okay.
And so
Puff is eBay's best matchup.
Yes. Well, as far as I can tell.
Okay.
And I think the evidence.
Like he did so good, like that's got to be his best matchup.
And he wore the Vino tag because he trains with Vino a lot.
Okay. That makes sense. Vino's a solid Puff.
I always make fun of them because like every time. So I've seen them at Big House. I saw them at Paragon, and I've seen them here. And they're playing on the same setup, even when they go to these tournaments.
That's funny.
Oh, dang. They're getting hype about something.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what. So I guess that's our top 16.
Yeah, that's the top 16.
Yeah, for the most part. Like now, I believe we can start moving on to predictions.
Oh, for top 8?
Yeah. Just like what we think is gonna happen.
Okay.
And like predictions, conjecture, etc. But hey, okay. We've got you here, and
okay,
it's
sure.
gonna be you versus Bladewise.
Okay.
How do you feel about Peach first
okay.
of all?
So. I'll go ahead and say public opinion is apparently that I'm not the best versus floaties due to the fact that, like, so one, I lost to MACD last time I played him.
Okay.
And then also because tech chasing is the main part of my game, supposedly, like, I'm apparently supposed to be worse versus floaties because I can't tech chase them. Uh-huh. But you saw, like, I knew how to combo
yeah,
Luigi.
You're great, man.
I can
you're
combo good. Peach just the same.
Yeah.
I played Bladewise at Big House. I won 2-0.
Nice.
But I will say that he supposedly... He said his control stick was messed up because he was trying to mash out of Nintendo's wobble so hard.
Oh.
Ooh.
So
I can't believe that.
So what happened
actually.
Is he had a very close game one with me, but I was ahead the whole time. And then game two, I beat Bladewise pretty badly. So yeah. It suggested to me sort of that the control stick was at least good enough to have an even game one, but I think it probably had some mental effect is my prediction. That
yeah.
maybe it bothered him, right?
Yeah.
He was like, man, I messed X up. The control stick bothered me. And then he played worse and then...
Yeah, like when one thing like gets to you in your mentality, it just kind of starts snowballing downhill.
Yeah,
definitely.
And it gets really hard to recover from that.
That's
and
so true.
Especially in Sheik Peach, I'd say I don't think it's that bad a matchup for Peach, but I think when Sheik is winning the matchup, it feels awful.
Yeah,
that's
it
one
does,
of the things
sure.
about that. Like when Sheik's winning the matchup, it's because she's totally in control. She stuffs you every time you do anything. You get needled if you try to move, and you're just like. This and you get the worst part is when you're losing and then you get grabbed and you die from the down throw affair, you come back and the first thing that happens is you get needle grabbed again. You're just like, I don't want to play anymore.
Yeah, it can definitely be a frustrating matchup for sure.
Yeah.
And so like it's one of those matchups where it's like a little bit harder to maintain your composure.
Yeah,
because
I think so.
Because you get frustrated. Sometimes you may get impatient. You know, similar to like Fox Puff. Like
oh, that's a
that. That's a matchup where either player can easily get very frustrated
yeah,
and lose their composure.
If you get behind and something goes wrong in Fox Puff, it's uh-huh. like,
yeah, you're just like, oh, that's it, man.
Yeah.
So I'd say my prediction is that I think I will win, but good. I know Bladewise is good, so I'm going to take it as seriously as I possibly can.
That's smart.
If I can force lock him every game, I'm going to try my hardest to.
Good.
Awesome. I know that's not going to happen, but that's what I'm going
to
try.
That's the best mentality to have, honestly.
I
it's just like,
yeah.
just go for it.
That's awesome.
I'm glad you like it, but like it's one of those things where I can say these things, but you know, actually emotionally feeling what I'm saying is like so much harder.
That's true.
Like I can say the right mentality, but having the right mentality.
That's another thing. Yeah.
Like to me, it's like, okay, you talk it up, talk it up, like I got the mentality. I got
helps
this.
Also.
Yeah, it helps. Yeah. And like you get built up to a point and then you play and then it like drops and you're like, oh, okay, you know, if I didn't talk myself up, it'd be down here though. So like at least I'm up here.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
But
then we have Silent Wolf Chip on the other side.
Yeah. And so like,
do you guys know about that? Anything?
A little bit.
Yeah.
I'm really curious about it. Everyone says Chip is good. Like that's.
Everyone says Chip is good.
Like
I
that.
Agree.
You know what I mean? When you're just like, oh, how about this player? Like, oh, dude, he's good. Like, and they do that thing.
It's a broad statement, though.
Yeah, it doesn't really tell us
and
too much.
It's like, it usually pertains to players that you don't see elsewhere.
Oh, okay.
But everyone knows, like, by playing them in friendlies, they're like, oh, yeah, they're really solid. They're pretty good. You know, they have the potential to make the upset.
I believe when Chip has attended Washington tournaments, like, in Seattle, because he lives, what, 3 or 4 hours out,
I
believe?
Yeah, 6 hours, I think.
Oh, 6 hours.
Yeah,
oh,
he lives
gosh.
Way out
That's
in
brutal.
Washington.
Yeah.
So when he's showed up to Seattle tournaments, he's done well? I believe.
I think so, yeah.
So you said you had thoughts on Silent Wolf Chip. Or What do you think?
Yeah, it's a great question. I was watching Chip's Marth play earlier. He was doing really well. You know, I think he's just like a really smart player. So like he knows how to react really well to situations. The thing is, but I mean, it's just, I hate to be, you know, biased towards Otto.
But
he's so good with the Marth, Sheik, especially Marth. He grew up playing Marth. It's like all day long. So, like, you know, it's really hard for me
hard
to
have a vote for Chip in this.
Yeah,
is what you're
it
saying.
Is.
Yeah, I mean.
As boring as it sounds.
I do think, like, it's possible. It is a possibility.
Yeah.
But, you know, smart money says that Otto's going to take it, and he's probably going to take
That's
it
3-0. Fair. It's kind of one of those funny things where you have this top 15 in the world player versus someone who no one outside of Washington probably really knows. But Chip has clearly shown, like, I believe he's been Bladewise in sets before.
Yeah.
Like, he's clearly up there, but we don't know exactly where.
Yeah. So there's an element of mystery.
Yeah. Okay, so that's the winner sets. So what are the losers matchups?
All right, losers matchups.
Oh, do we want to talk about... So we know Silent Wolf usually beats Bladewise, right?
Yeah.
Yes, okay.
So if I beat Bladewise, though, what do you guys honestly... Anything okay. about Silent Wolf versus me?
Yeah.
You guys can talk if you want, and okay. I have my
sure.
thoughts, obviously.
I was saying earlier, like... Silent Wolf is a player that has been criticized for being bad at the Sheik matchup. Like,
okay,
he's like what people say is that he's good at everything else, but when he goes against the Sheik matchup, which is supposed to be in the Fox favor,
he hasn't been as strong.
Yeah, he falls short in a few areas partly because there's no strong Sheiks up here.
Okay,
but I do believe I heard he beat you at a HTC.
So his HTC run. Yeah. So I have my thoughts on how good he is at the matchup, but outside of that, just results wise, yeah. he did beat me. Mewtwo King and Shroomed at HTC.
That's right. Yeah, he ran straight through Sheiks
yep.
yeah. at HTC.
So and at HTC specifically, he had a good day versus Sheik for sure.
Yeah.
So I can at least say that.
Yeah, he's good versus Sheik now.
What were you going to say?
I was going to say, I watched your guys' sets, and some of those matches were so close. Like,
yeah.
Oh, my gosh. And it looks like from what I saw, you got a little bit shaky on a couple of the matches, which is, I'm sure... You know, it wasn't a big deal, but I think it might have made all the difference.
I think, okay, so my thoughts are yeah. exactly what you said.
Okay.
So I will yeah. say, I don't know if you know, but we played two sets at HTC. So okay. I upset Mango, and that put me up versus yeah. Silent Wolf for a winner's quarters, I believe.
That's
and
right.
he 2-0'd me in winners, but I dropped, so my tech chases are supposedly so big, I dropped nearly all of them.
Oh.
So yeah. If I drop tech chases versus Fox, especially someone yeah. like Otto, I'm not going to
beat
him.
On that subject, right. actually, I did see you dropping a few of them versus Eggs yesterday. Like, are you feeling better today, like tech chase-wise?
So what I'll say versus Eggs is how hard I try to tech chase perfectly is dependent on the Fox's skill level. The better the Fox, the more I feel pressure to tech chase perfectly, because if I mess up my tech chasing by reacting slow and getting shined, that gives the Fox player a lot higher chance to beat me. If I... sort of reacted and tried to grab tech in place and I didn't react and they rolled, at least he's not hitting me, right?
Right.
So yeah. I'm much more okay dropping punishes on Fox players that aren't quite top level Foxes. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does.
Because I feel confident that even if I drop this, I'm still probably going to win.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Versus
so
Silent Wolf, though, I'm not going to be like, oh, I'm going to miss half my punishes and beat him.
Uh-huh.
No one's going to do that.
Right.
Versus Silent Wolf, I'm like, all right, I'm going to have to hit these punishes. So at HTC, I tried that. I wasn't too on point with it. We play in losers. It was 3-2.
Yeah.
I did hit a lot more of my punishes. Like you said, I think the main difference is that because I think the burden is on Sheik to drop the punishes,
yeah.
it's more stressful. So it's stressful and neutral for both of us. And once Fox gets a hit, he's just like, all right, I'm going to do my combo.
Yeah.
When Sheik gets a hit, I have to try twice as hard.
That's true.
So when I get something wrong, I think that's what made the difference. Because otherwise, I thought pretty
yeah.
even.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And then we had the so Marth Fox game 5. I was up 3-1, and he made the comeback.
Oh,
right. So, like, you felt like it was just, like, the punishes were much harsher, Fox going on Sheik?
I think Sheik hits Fox harder, but Fox has an easier time hitting Sheik.
Right, so he gets more consistent punishes.
Yep. So, yeah. We're playing for fourth place at a national. We've been, HTC specifically, we were at the tournament for, it's a 12-hour day.
Oh, it was man. A
one-day tournament.
Yeah, that was a long day.
I was
day.
Honestly, like, it's not a John. It's just like it's hard to focus for that long.
Yeah.
I need to be able to, but I was not able to.
Yeah, it's completely true. When you play a tournament for that long, your focus will go down and your play will go down. It's just that simple. It's extremely difficult to remain consistent all throughout the day.
That's all it is, and I think Fox has the advantage in that sense. But as I get better, I hope that will go away, and I can just be like, all right, I know I'm gonna.
Yeah.
Play well.
Yeah, you can do it, man. Yeah.
So what about the losers top 8?
All right, yeah, let's check out losers. All right, so Eggs versus eBay.
Okay.
Yeah. We talked about that a little bit.
Just a little,
but,
yeah.
But, okay, so just like the Fox-Falcon matchup, it's pretty rough. Once Fox gets those punishes in, and when Fox punishes Falcon, it's more of like a set thing, and it's like, okay, you know, like you can DI this way or that way, but I can follow you pretty easily.
Yeah, Fox has a great combo game.
Yeah.
No questions.
But then when Falcon punishes Fox, he's like, I got to read you. I have to know where you're going.
Okay.
Otherwise, this isn't going to work quite as well.
Yeah. It's interesting because I'm comparing this match, you know, eBay versus Eggs with Otto, Silent Wolf versus eBay.
Okay.
You know, watching how eBay played Silent Wolf, he was really careful, really kind of played on the defensive.
Okay.
Like I was saying earlier, he was consistent. And so that's something Eggs, you know, he really tries to throw people off with a lot of stuff. So I think for eBay, it'll be he'll have an easier time playing
in Ace. Some senses.
Yeah, in some senses, because he won't be so overwhelmed by all the stuff Otto does, but. In other senses, Eggs really does know how to put on pressure when he wants to.
Yeah, so it'll be. You think it'll be a pretty different set?
Yeah, definitely different.
Okay.
Absolutely different.
I do think, like, just thinking about Eggs' playstyle, I do think he might be in trouble because he always likes to go for the flashier stuff.
He does.
Unless he decides to play safe for whatever reason, he does go for a lot of the flashier stuff, which leaves him a little bit more open.
Okay.
So I think maybe he, like, might be in a little bit of trouble.
Yeah.
Right there.
One thing I'll say about Eggs' playstyle is in every match I've seen him play, he uses platforms a lot.
He does.
Falcon is one of the few matchups where I think using platforms a lot is not that great because Falcon has up air.
Yeah.
Falcon can really run up to the top of the stage. He can, if Fox is coming down, Falcon can run to the other side. Like, he has a lot of answers.
That's
so
true.
I wonder if Eggs will stay with his platform strategy, how if eBay will effectively counter it, or if Eggs is going to be like, no, I know this matchup is different. I'm not going to be focused on platforms as much.
Yeah, that's a great question.
So I'm really interested in that aspect.
Yeah, it'll be interesting. It'll be awesome to see.
So then our last top eight match
All right. Was it Iceman?
Yeah.
Or Iceman beat Scion?
No, it's Scion versus
Cawmaster.
Have you played Scion?
I've never played Scion.
Never played Scion.
And Scion is a fox, correct?
No, he's the Falco player.
He's,
I believe, from Western Canada.
Okay.
And back in the day, he was known to be not like the top tier Falco, but sort of the tier below that,
which is
still very good. He's a very good player. He's known for being fast, aggressive, etc.
Yeah.
He beat Iceman in a very close set, and the matches he won were he was going in. And the matches he lost, he tried to go in. Uh-huh. Marth got a hit and, you know, did his thing. So how do you feel about Luigi Falco?
I hate it.
Okay, totally. I 100% agree. Do you have any more thoughts besides I hate it?
Or is it
literally just like, hate this matchup, like, I don't want to play it? Like,
oh, yeah. On stages with platforms, it's a little bit easier, I think.
But 3 out of 5.
3 out of 5.
You think he'll take it to FD?
I think he probably will, yeah. There's some rumors back in the day that I used to be really good on FD against Spaces, but, you know, that's like the kind of the same thing as Mewtwo used to kill everybody on FD.
Yeah, I remember that.
Era, right?
Dude, Taj on FD.
Yeah, Taj on FD. Yeah. So, things have changed.
Yeah.
But, in general, you know, if the Falco has Luigi matchup, if Scion has Luigi matchup experience, that'll make a big difference. It'll make it almost really difficult for me. But if he doesn't, it's like that'll be huge in my favor.
When you fight people, how quickly do you notice their experience level versus Luigi?
Usually it's as soon as they ledge guard.
So you use that as your sign.
Yeah, definitely. That's the best gauge usually. And if they're really careful with like how they approach, then I know that they usually know what kind of punishes Luigi can do. So those are two of my biggest gauges.
Okay.
That and DI, probably.
So I think, especially for people who play characters that are less common, I think one of the most useful skills is figuring out what your opponent knows about your character as fast as possible.
Yeah,
so like you, so for everyone out there, it's like, Cawmaster's like, okay, how they edgeguard Luigi is immediately going to indicate to me how much experience they have versus Luigi.
Yeah.
And that can guide your other decisions. You're like, people who don't know how to fight Luigi are more likely to get hit by this thing.
Uh-huh.
Like, I know certain players will, like, have certain tech patterns when they haven't fought Luigi much, and the players that know how to fight Luigi tend to tech away more,
right? You're very
right. Then you can go for the reads on that.
Yeah, that's a great point. Thank you. I'm going to use that.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure you'll notice as soon as you play Scion. But at the same time, Falco Luigi is...
It's a hard matchup,
it's
man.
So hard.
So hard.
I don't know if you know, but Abate beat Zoo a couple months
Really?
Back. It was like 6 or 7 months back. But
oh, wow.
I will say, so it was 3-2.
Uh-huh.
And every game Zoo won of the set, he almost four-stocked Abate.
No way.
And he still lost the set in 3 close games.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
So I think when Falco has it down, he...
He has it down.
Blows him out of the water. Yeah. But Abate won.
That's crazy.
Is it just it's because of like getting pinned down by lasers?
Yeah, right? And I think Zoo's definitely a player where like once he figures out what like laser patterns and spacings he needs to like shut you down, like it's so over.
That's so true.
On the flip side, I don't know if Abate. I didn't watch carefully enough to be like, Abate adapted really well, or if it was just like Zoo wasn't able to do it every game because that's so hard, right?
Yeah, it's so hard.
I think one of the only players we've seen be able to play at that skill level is like Armada. Yeah. If he four stocks you one game, he's probably still gonna four stock you the next game, you know?
That's true.
Yeah, Armada's amazing.
He is. Yeah, so that should be interesting.
So that's our top eight?
Yeah, that's our top eight. We can actually move on to predictions at this point.
So for each set? We didn't talk about...
For each set.
So eggs or eBay?
Yeah.
What do you guys think?
We did talk about the prediction between Silent Wolf and you.
We talked about it.
We talked about that at length, so we can skip that. And we talked about you versus Bladewise as well. Eggs versus
eBay, right?
Yeah, eggs and eBay. Okay,
well,
so
we talked to Silent Wolf Chip. We sort of talked about that too.
Yeah.
We
said a little bit.
It's sort of outlandish to predict a chip win.
It would definitely be an upset.
The smart money says that Otto is just going to kind of do a steamroll 3-0, probably 2-3 stocks.
Maybe two stocks per game.
We'll see. I would say that's my prediction.
I think
is
one
two
game
stocks.
Could be a 3 stock for sure. I think one game will be a 3 stock, and I'm not sure about the rest.
Yeah.
So eggs eBay votes.
Eggs eBay.
I'm gonna give the edge to eggs for sure. I think this is something that eBay can do, though. It's definitely not outside the
realm
of
possibility. It's probably not going to be a blowout on either side.
No.
Okay. What's the crowd doing? All right, so what do you think, eggs or eBay?
Yeah, relying mostly on looking at tournament results, I think eggs played eBay a few months ago in an Oregon tournament.
Okay.
Or maybe it was a different Falcon, but yeah, he got the win. It was super close, though.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
So as far as you know, eggs beat eBay last time.
Yeah, eggs beat eBay, yeah.
Okay, I have heard that eBay has beaten him before.
Okay.
So I don't know who to give it to, but I definitely think it'll be a very – I don't expect a blowout for sure. I expect an even set. I expect a 3-2 or 3-1 for sure.
Yeah.
It won't be a blowout from either player by any means. It's going to be pretty even. It'll really be anybody's game. Like, you can't actually say who's going to win this.
But you give the edge to eggs for – reason, like Fox Falcon, Eggs is a more experienced player.
Yeah. Right.
Well, like, there's the matchup thing, and also I'm Oregon, so.
Oh, you're Oregon. So you're like, yes. I gotta go Eggs.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, so. Yeah, and so then we got Comaster Scion.
Yeah, Comaster Scion.
And we talked a little bit about that.
I'll go ahead and say I don't know how. If Scion knows anything about Luigi, I have no clue. If he's good versus Luigi, I'm gonna give it to Scion. That's how Falcon. But if he knows nothing about Luigi, I mean. That can go bad real quick.
You're right.
When somebody doesn't know how to fight Luigi, it's super ugly. Yeah.
Luigi
so ugly for them, and he'll dance circles around them all day long.
It's true.
Do you feel confident?
I feel pretty confident.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you been playing much? I don't know how often you play or.
Not that often. No, actually, in Hawaii, I was playing pretty often.
Oh, so in Hawaii you were playing. Yeah. So you don't feel like rusty or anything. You're
not,
just like.
Not too rusty. There's a few little things, just
okay,
like timing.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, but no, not nothing too bad. Yeah, and so any Falco that I feel like I don't know, I haven't heard of. And
you feel like, okay, I should be
I feel
fine
like I have a good
him.
Chance.
Okay, that's fair.
Yeah.
And real quick, I just wanted to say we haven't mentioned Northwest Majors in a little bit. But so, yeah, we're here at Northwest Majors tournament in
drop
Des Moines.
Zone.
Yeah, Drop Zone. Northwest Majors Drop Zone, the Smash-only rendition of Northwest Majors in Des Moines, Washington at Highline Community College. And we've got a pretty good tournament going. We have Drug Fox here, Calm Master here.
I think that definitely brought a little hype. We had me come here last minute, and then it was like, guys, Comaster's coming. And like,
I got some hype.
I'm pretty happy both of you guys made it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm happy to be here. And I got to meet Comaster, which is cool.
At the legendary Luigi player, Comaster.
this tournament's been cool. It's a great venue. Great venue. Lots of people here. I mean, it's been great. Production value seems pretty
dude,
Gimby Fish is going in with the – high-quality videos and pictures. I think you guys will see in Top 8 what he's gotten ready.
I've been working with Slash to get those ready as well, and saw what Gimby Fish was doing. It's gonna look real sick. We're gonna have a Evo type feel to our Top 8 intro. It's gonna be awesome. But yeah, dude, Slash, I can't overemphasize how good he is at like programming like stream control, and like this setup is nuts. As somebody who has a complicated setup, this setup is insane.
That's like, awesome.
It's fantastic. We got a great staff, great tournament going on right now. And, if you guys are still watching from the front page, feel free to click on the stream itself, and that will take you to our page, and you can join us from the main channel.
And I guess if this happens again next year, I will definitely say people should come out.
Awesome. Yeah.
No question. It's been great.
I think we have a Northwest Majors every few months.
Oh, yeah, there was the one in spring, I believe. Aiden was telling me.
Yeah, there was Northwest Regionals, I believe is what it was.
Okay.
And there was one about a month before that. And I think we're having another one in April.
Okay.
Thereabouts. And I think that's just going to be a straight up another Northwest Major. So it's going to be like Northwest Majors 8 or something.
Nice.
Like that. Okay. And that's going to be all the fighting games plus
Melee
and probably Smash 4.
Okay.
Sweet.
Oh, we got, sorry to interrupt, but we got Otto and Teddy playing,
oh, yeah.
I assume PM, like, winners finals or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Anytime they play anything is really great. But we're going to check out the bracket a little bit more after plugging this tournament. And what we were just talking about, we're talking about you versus Sion.
So then we would have either Comaster or Sion versus either Eggs or eBay.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Eggs.
Oh, okay, so do you feel confident versus Eggs?
I thought I did, but I played him over the past couple days for first time in a long time, and he's gotten a lot better.
Oh, really?
So my confidence dropped pretty quickly.
But you think you can beat him, though?
I'd say it's 50-50.
Okay.
Yeah. So like,
so before you were like, all right, I got Eggs.
Yeah, like
now you're like, oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, okay, something I've been wondering about for a long time, like how dominant were you in Old Washington?
Okay. Yeah.
Like 5 minutes.
We're being told. Okay.
Okay. Cool. We got so
Smash 4 analysis coming soon.
Yeah. We got Smash 4 analysis coming up after us.
You were talking about Washington dominance.
I don't think we have time now, though.
Yeah, okay. We probably don't have too much time for that.
No worries.
I
predict Drug Fox on Wolf Grand Finals. It's going to be sweet.
That seems like a safe prediction, but we'll see if any upsets happen.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, I think that's pretty safe, too. Like I said, I think...
Oh, what's the stream link, by the way? I'm sorry. Just so I can tweet it out, tell people, hey, guys.
Mainstream Team Chaos.
Team K-H-A-O-S.
K-H-A-O-S, yeah.
And that's it. Team There's no, like, gaming or anything.
Team Chaos, yeah.
Team Chaos.
Yeah. Not gaming or anything, just Team Chaos. Okay. I thought it was Chaos Gaming, but that's a secondary stream.
Yeah, that's a difference.
Twitch.tv/TeamChaos.
So everyone share the link. Top 8 starts at 7 p.m. Pacific time.
Holy cow, I didn't know it was that late.
Yeah, it's pretty late. I was actually really surprised because it was like, be here by noon to play. Yeah. Play one round, 7 p.m.
Yeah.
But it's understandable. Yeah. There's so many games here.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So 7 p.m. PST, tune in to Melee Top 8. I guess there will be Top 8s before that.
There will be Top 8s before that. I think it's... Oh, we have the schedule right here, literally.
Oh, okay. So read off.
Look at that. All right, so at 7 p.m., we're going to have Melee Top 8. That's going to be the very last one. Just before that, we're going to have Smash 4 Top 8. Actually, it's going to be the Smash 4 Analyst Panel, and then it's going to be Smash 4 Top 8, followed directly by Melee Top 8 at 7 o'clock.
Okay. I'm excited to watch, honestly.
Yeah, I'm excited to watch, too.
As much as I'm like, I'm not, it's like not I'm not excited to play Bladewise and Silent Wolf and like whoever else, but I'm like more honestly interested. I'm like, oh, I want to see Sion versus Comet. I'm like, oh, I have no clue what's going to happen.
Yeah.
That's like a matchup like I've never heard of before.
It's so much fun to watch those matchups where you really, like just between players that you're like, I have no idea who's going to win this.
Like,
and they're
I
both good.
I want to see Silent Wolf Chip because Otto's combo game is disgusting.
It is.
And Chip, I think so. He's a little worse for Spaces than I think some of the other matchups, but he, like everyone said, he's clearly a smart player.
Yeah,
and, I mean, Marth Fox is one of those matchups where if Marth plays pretty smart and avoids Fox, like, he can get his hits, he can get his punishes. Like, even if Otto's DI is good, like, you can still kill him, you know?
Yeah.
Definitely.
But, yeah, like, moving on, we got a few more minutes here. So, let's say Eggs beats eBay.
Okay.
And then Eggs would be fighting the loser of AD. Which would either be you or Bladewise?
Eggs versus me or Bladewise. So if it was me, it would be a run back. I did win 2-0, so I'm not crazy worried. But, I mean, Eggs is good.
Yeah.
Do we know Eggs Bladewise? Anything?
That's always been back and forth.
It is a little back and forth. And, like, it really depends on how Eggs is playing. If Eggs is playing at the top of his game, then it's going to be very even. And it's gonna be really, really tough to call.
So it's either even or in Bladewise's favor.
Basically,
If Eggs plays great, it'll be a good set. If he doesn't play great, Peach might run away with it a little.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's pretty much what we're looking at. And then Comaster, if you beat Sion, you'll be against the loser of AC.
Which is Silent Wolf Chip.
Yeah, which is Silent Wolf Chip.
Whoa.
And so you'll probably be fighting Chip.
Okay, wait. So say that one more time. If I beat Sion, who will...
You'll play... Chip if he loses to Silent Wolf.
Okay.
So your group of four is a group of four where I want to see all of you played. I really want to see you not only play Sion, but I'd love to see you play Chip and Silent Wolf.
I will.
But I'd also love to see Sion play Silent Wolf and Chip.
That's
like,
true, yeah.
Those all sound like great matches.
Yeah, you're right. I like your enthusiasm.
Yeah. Yeah, then we might just end up seeing you and Silent Wolf in winner's finals.
Yep.
And don't know how that's going to go, but...
Yeah, I don't know. I have no clue.
Actually, I really don't know how that's going to go.
I will say if I can tech chase at the level I feel like I can in friendlies, I feel favored versus him. I feel like if I tech chase my average tournament level, it'll be a pretty even set, but I give him the slight edge. And if I tech chase any worse than that, I do not see myself beating him, for sure.
Okay.
Where do you want to go? What stage do you want to go?
Okay, so this is pretty weird.
Actually, we got to wrap it up.
Okay. We can talk about this later, but all right. Good. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in.
Waltz, Locke, and
Jeremy Toast is what we heard for Smash 4 analysis.
I think that's what I heard. But so thanks for joining us for the Melee Analysis Desk.
Yeah.
We're going to be passing it off to the Smash 4 analysis guys who we just talked about.
It was fun talking to you guys.
Yeah, you too.
It was fun. Yeah. Let's do the thing.
We can talk about me versus Otto in a second.
Yeah, of course.
All right, cool.
Thanks for watching, guys. Smash 4 coming up.